I'm going to show you how to pop up a trend screen from a faceplate in WinCC version 7.4 or 7.5. You'll be able to select different faceplates and show relevant trends for each one. So if this sounds useful to you, stick around and I'll show you how to do it. Recently, subscriber Cenan Adamus asked if we could put a button on a faceplate instance in WinCC 7.4 to pull up relevant trends to that faceplate. Now, in WinCC version 8, you may recall a new feature where you can launch a pop-up screen directly from a faceplate. But in WinCC 7.4, it's not so easy. So let's take a look at how to get this done in WinCC 7.4. First, in Graphics Designer, create your Trends pop-up screen. Go ahead and add trends for the values you want to show. Don't worry about setting up the tag name. We're going to do that with a script. Next, on our faceplate object, I'm going to add a button that we can use to pull up the Trends window. I'll configure it the way that I want it, and I'm going to give it a name so that I can identify it later. Next, we're going to need to configure the faceplate type. We'll go to the Events tab and we'll select our button. We're going to add a couple of button events so that we can trigger a VBS script to show the relevant trends when this faceplate instance is clicked. We're going to update all instances and save. Back on our PID loop screen where our faceplate instances are shown, I'm going to add a picture window. I will double-click the picture name property and select the FP Trends screen to show in this. I'm going to disable display because we don't want to see it all the time, but only when the faceplate is clicked. We're going to turn on sizable, movable, border, title, and closable to make it a pop-up screen. Finally, we're going to select adapt size so it will size itself to the picture. Next, we're going to give it a name so we can easily pick it out of a list. Then I'll save. Next, we're going to add a script to our faceplate instances. But before we get into that, let's take a look at our setup. We have tags for CV, PV, and SP for each of our faceplates. Also, when you set up a trend window manually, you generally add trends to a given trend window and associate a time and value axis and colors. We'll be doing all of this only from a script. The purpose of the script is to show relevant tags to the PID where we click the trend button. And you can see here we've updated the header. This is PID 1 trends. And we can see that these trends are connected to the tags for PIV 1. Here we show the same window, but for the tags on PID 2. And finally, we're showing the same window, but with the tags for 3. So let's go review the script. I've set the VB script on our left button down event for our trends button. In the script, first we create some variables for the picture window and various interfaces on the trend control that's on the pop-up. We'll set our provider to 2, which is live tag data, but you could set it to 1 and get archive tag data. The PID index is just the index of the PID we're on. This is for number 1. First, we'll set a reference to our picture window showing the pop-up and set its visibility to true. We need to do this so that we can set a reference in the next line to the actual trend control. We're going to turn off visibility to the trend control so that we can make some changes and have it update. We'll update the caption to show which PID we're looking at. Next, we're going to set some references to the trend window object on the trend control, as well as the time and value axis. And we'll set the time and value axis to access our trend window. Next, we'll get the trend that we named SP, set it to the online provider, and tell it to hook up to SP underscore 1, which is the value of our PID index. We'll set the trend window to our current trend window, as well as the current time and value axis. Then we'll do the same for our PV and our CV. Finally, we're going to make it visible so that we can see the trends. We'll set all of our references to nothing for housekeeping. Looking at the scripts on 2 and 3, we only have to change the PID index to build the correct tag name. The end result is we can press the trend screen button and show trends for our selected PID loop. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you got something good out of it, I'd really appreciate it if you would subscribe, like, and share this video. It will help me continue making this content and bringing it to you on this channel. Thanks for watching.